gravity or g-forces on impact and then call for help for you.
Now Rollins, first generation.
Hall of Fame in Dexton, and covering this for us now is Matt Wolf. That's where we kick off our Mixtape Monday.
Sup, girl? You know, it's Mixtape Monday, right? So I made you this special mix just for you.
Just gonna say, we know that you were in Cleveland for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony.
Did you go to that Jack Casino? That's a good time.
Guys, I did not make it to the Jack Casino, but I did make it to the Christmas Story House, which was pretty cool. It's about 10 minutes outside town of downtown Cleveland proper, and that was adventurous. The beer was adventurous, and so was the food. Cleveland's got a lot to offer, and I'm not just saying that.
No, it does.
It's actually a very cool city.
I complained about it each time I had to spend a week there, but had a blast. It is a good time, and the jewel is the Hall of Fame Museum, yeah. I think. It's a really, even if you're not super into music, it's just like, it's cool, like, trip down a historical lane, you know?
It really is, and, you know, that flipping over to the actual ceremony itself, you know, for the inductions this past weekend, which was at the Rocket Mortgage Arena, right downtown, and this, of course, being guys the first time back. You know, last year, the ceremony was all virtual, and this year, you know, as a member of the press for ABC, I'm backstage, and we're seeing each other, you know, all the different people from all the different outlets, and we're all looking at each other like, did this last year and 9 months really happen? You know, we're all just kind of like, we're back! We think, yeah, it's a little creepy still with the masks and everything, but, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, and I'm telling you guys, I cannot wait for you to see this thing. November 20th on HBO. There is so much to talk about, so hit me up. What do you got?
Well, I was fascinated by the Dave Chappelle appearance, only because, I mean, he's an Ohio guy now. That's where he lives, but I know that, I'm sure that probably generated quite a bit of buzz. Just, if for nothing else, how much controversy surrounds the guy, Dave Chappelle, right now?
Well, exactly, and, you know, when he walked out onto the stage to induct Jay-Z, you know, there was this awkward kind of hush in the press room, and we're all just like, oh boy, what's going to happen here? Like, this could be interesting, or it could be a complete dumpster fire. I don't know what to say, you know, and he comes out, he says, I want to start by saying I'm sorry, and everyone just sort of went, and then he goes, nope, I'm just messing around. And then he went straight into the induction and his speech and that sort of thing. Stayed completely off topic of everything that was going on with Netflix, because I think he didn't want it to overshadow, obviously, the night, you know, for Jay-Z, LL Cool J, Carole King, the Go-Go's, Foo Fighters, and even Sir Paul McCartney being in the house, you know?
Yeah, so, star-studded. Absolutely. Jay-Z seems to be the guy stealing the headlines, but LL Cool J as well. Who else?
Let me tell you something real quick about LL Cool J. When you watch that performance, if you've seen LL in concert, this is a guy who leaves everything on the stage, and boy, did he do it on Saturday night, because he brings out Eminem and surprise appearance from Jennifer Lopez, too, to sing their songs. He did like a greatest hits medley, and he was pretty impressive, I'll tell you, but the belle of the ball, guys, was Carole King backstage. When I tell you, Jay-Z beelined past a bunch of people to get a photograph with Carole King, you know you're in rarefied air right there. I mean, everybody was worshiping her, and she really is that American treasure.
She has her fingerprints on so many people's music and career for decades. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. And opening the show, wait till you guys see it, is Taylor Swift. And she comes out and she does this absolutely smoldering version of Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow. I'm not going to give away too much, but that was one of the other times where us in the front room were looking at each other and we're like, oh my goodness, she's really doing this and going there and doing it well.
That is so cool that you were there. How come we have to wait so long to see it?
auctions are held in like the late spring, you know, sort of around that area. But because of COVID and the way things went.
Oh, I'm going to take a picture of it. I'm going to talk about it. Sarah, that's not.